How to face group discussion. A group discussion consists of communication skills, knowledge and ideas regarding a given subject, capability to coordinate and lead, exchange of thoughts, addressing the group as a whole. Communication skills. The first aspect is one's power of expression. In a group discussion, a candidate has to talk effectively so that he is able to convince others. For convincing, one has to speak forcefully and at the same time create an impact by his knowledge of the subject. A candidate who is successful in holding the attention of the audience creates a positive impact. It is necessary that you should be precise and clear. As a rule, evaluators do not look for the wordage produced. Your knowledge on a given subject, your precision and clarity of thoughts are the things that are evaluated. Irrelevant talks lead you nowhere. You should speak as much as necessary, neither more nor less. Group discussions are not debating stages. Ability to listen is also what evaluators judge. They look for your ability to react on what other participants say. Hence, it is necessary that you listen carefully to others and then react or proceed to add some more points. Your behavior in the group is also put to test to judge whether you are a loner or can work in a group. You should be able to convey your thoughts satisfactorily and convincingly before a group of people. Confidence and level-headedness is doing so is necessary. These add value to your presentation. In case you are not good at it, you might gain by joining an institute that offers specialized course in public speaking. Knowledge and ideas regarding a given subject. Knowledge of the subject under discussion and clarity of ideas are important. Knowledge comes from consistent reading on various topics ranging from science and technology to politics. In-depth knowledge makes one confident and enthusiastic, and this in turn makes one sound, convincing and confident. Leadership and coordinating capabilities. The basic aim of a group discussion is to judge a candidate's leadership qualities. The examiner withdraws and becomes a silent spectator once the discussion starts. A candidate should display tactfulness, skill, understanding and knowledge on varied topics, enterprise, forcefulness and other leadership qualities to motivate and influence other candidates who may be almost equally competent. Exchange of thoughts. A group discussion is an exchange of thoughts and ideas among members of a group. These discussions are held for selecting personnel in organizations where there is a high level of competition. The number of participants in a group can vary between 8 and 15. Mostly, a topic or a situation is given to group members who have discussed it within 10 to 20 minutes. The purpose is to get an idea about candidates in a short time and make assessments about their skills, which normally cannot be evaluated in an interview. These skills may be team membership, leadership skills, listening and articulation skills. A note is made of your contributions to the discussion, comprehension of the main idea, the rapport you strike, patience, assertion, accommodation, amenability, etc. Body language and eye contact, two are important points which are to be considered. Addressing the group as a whole. In a group discussion, it is not necessary to address anyone by name. Even otherwise, you may not know everyone's names. It is better to address the group as a whole. Address the person farthest from you. If he can hear you, everyone else too can. Needless to add, as for the interview, attend the group discussion in formal dress. The language used should also be formal, not the language used in normal conversations. For instance, words and phrases like yaar, chalta hai, CP, I do know, etc. are out. This is not to say you should use a high sounding, pedantic language. Avoiding both, just use formal, plain and simple language. Hinglish means mixture of Hindi and English should be discarded. Confidence and coolness while presenting your viewpoint are of help. See that you do not keep repeating a point. Do not use more words than necessary. Do not be superfluous. Try to be specific. Do not exaggerate.